Canada. That's on.
Terve terve, my summer carers. Today I collected all the developers' answer from the official forum and from reliable information leaks. And I am glad to announce that there are a huge number of facts about the new game. The developer, Topless Gun, can't keep the intrigue, confirming one user guess after another. In the beginning of the year, Topless Gun presented a gameplay teaser of the game with a working car and a winter environment. My Winter Car is not just the second part of your favorite game, but its logical and plot sequel. The new game will take place a couple of years after the events of My Summer Car, but no later than year 2000. The protagonist, Sol Tatsuma, moved from his parents' house to a rented apartment closer to a city and took financial responsibility for the newly born daughter. Compared to My Summer Car, emphasis is much more on economics. In addition, the player will find himself in a harsh and endless Finnish winter, looked somewhere between December or January, trying not to freeze to death. It looks like the developer has nothing sacred left. Let's talk about everything in order. The goal of the game remains the same. After the sale of our supercar, we have to assemble a new car again, having only the body in our own. Our new project car is a Ford Taunus, made in the German division of Ford. Over time, it turned out that it would be its first generation, TC1. Inside the game, the 25-year-old car was named Coris Ribiat. We learned about it from the teaser, and the manufacturer Coris appeared in My Summer Car in a mini-game on the local computer, Rally 95. The Ribiat's engine is simple enough, a 1.6-liter inline 4-cylinder that gives out 71 horses in stock. Considering the weight of the car of 1 ton, the engine's abilities raise many questions in me. The developer chose the inline engine due to its ease of assembly. For the same reasons, there will be no turbine in the game. This engine in the real world has no rev limiter. So you may ask how the piston group will behave in the game. A small hint, it will behave flawlessly. Because of this feature, the developer can make an assistant that would limit revs for those who play with the keyboard. By the way, many people wanted the ability to start the car by pushing it, but Topless Gun wrote that it was impossible to program. The gas engine consumes 19 miles per gallon, which will obviously delight Tamer, the store owner who will be in the game and will develop his business, will expand the range of products, apparently at our expense. At the beginning of the game, we will be able to choose the difficulty of the game. In hard mode, we will have to seek and buy spare parts for a new car all over the map. The sources will be completely different: used parts sellers, catalogs, purchases from a mechanic, and a good old trash landfill. Spare parts are a separate topic. The developer promises detailed assembly of the car, but there will be something extra. He said that, like in My Summer Car, Ribiat can be upgraded with many extras, like Satsuma GT. This will include such option as replacing the camshaft with an advanced one, the ability to install parts from later Ford models such as Sierra or Capri, as well as some good old parts from My Summer Car catalog, but this is just the tip of the iceberg. Like in My Summer Car, some parts may break. The difference is that there will be more breaking parts. But on the other hand, comes one thing that I really wanted: the ability to buy duplicates of the same part. It will be great, as will the ability to upgrade your car. Because in stock, even by my standards, we get a total sadness. A 4-speed manual transmission is capable to accelerate this Ford to an incredible 91 miles per hour. Okay, in winter conditions, of course, it will be difficult to accelerate to the maximum speed. Harsh conditions and real-wheel drive kind of give us a slight hint of drifting. The developer said that the car is heavier, bigger, and has much more bottom and torque. You could even say that it is closer to the Ferndale than Satsuma, but of course, because it is winter, it is also very slippery, more slippery than Ferndale on dirt. This combination gives us two other ideas. In short, the differential can also be welded. And you can take sandbags with you for better downforce on the rear wheels. And when you get stuck in the snow after another drift, you can sand the road to get out of this snowdrift. Thus, as I expected, there will be summer tires and winter studded tires. In my winter car, a player will be able to change the car's interior. On the teaser, we could already see how the car would look inside. The dashboard is made of wood and chrome, with a Rivet logo and a yellow gauge backlight, with a tachometer and a battery indicator. It is planned to add a real steering wheel from the Escort MK2 to the game. The car will have a radio and a working heater. The heater can fail and leave you freezing, as well as other spare parts in the game. How accurately you assemble the car will be checked by the same vehicle inspection. If everything is okay, you will be given a license plate, your own unique number.
Oh, now it's better.
The developer said that the car is pretty much done, including wiring and seats. It is missing some minor details like clutch cable install, gearbox bracket, and more tuning parts. At the moment, the car is on hold and I'm working on another large feature that is completely new. I think that when it is ready, it will be the most complex complete system after a car I have done to these two games. Fun thing is that probably no one cares about the feature, but it needs to be made. This is my winter car. Contrary to the fantasy of the players, it will be possible to assemble only one car, but as we already know from my summer car, the gameplay is never limited just to one car. Let's talk about cars we've lost. There will be no Satsuma in the game, in any form. The developer considered it too irrational to remake it into a low-poly model. We will not see a station wagon and a minivan. The mechanic's muscle car will be replaced with another American car. The boat on the frozen lake seems to be nothing. People have been trying to guess an additional car on which we can explore the map, but so far nobody has figured it out. First, the Mercedes W123 was discussed, then the first generation diesel Golf LX. Topless Gun did not confirm any of them. However, it is known that the auxiliary car will need basic maintenance, such as an oil change. Write in the comments what kind of car it can be and when my winter car comes out, and we all will find out about it. The first one who guesses it will get a licensed copy of my winter car in Steam. But quite unexpectedly, the good old Rattles from My Summer Car were confirmed. The sheet truck, the tractor and the moped will remain in the game. There is also a rumor that we will be able to put chains on the wheels of the tractor. All of this come along with quests associated with these vehicles. Some say that work in the sheet truck and the tractor will be complicated by the lack of a heater. The heater will be on the bus that we will drive. We will make a penny transporting grannies from one bus stop to another. The players assume that the construction site in My Summer Car, which is near the intersection at the entrance to Perajärvi, is the bus station. The action of the new game will take place on the same map. It will be renewed with new buildings, but in general it will remain the same. These will be settlements around one large frozen lake. My winter car is a premium sheet. We will be able to take part in races on the ice, and if we shorten the way across the lake on a heavy sheet truck, we will fall through the ice. Speaking about the map, of course, we need to understand where the main character will live, because by that time he had already moved out from his parents. The most obvious is the apartment in Perajärvi, in a red house, next to the one where the drunk guy moved. It is known that you will have to pay rent for accommodation. What will happen if you do not pay? We will find out when the game is released. If we think about an apartment, then will we have a garage at all? Where will we assemble a new car in the middle of winter? What will happen to the parents' house, and will the old garage be available? Nobody knows. In general, there were many assumptions. The protagonist could live in his grandmother's house if she dies, or in his uncle's empty house. Yes, there won't be some characters in the game, and this brings us new feature of My Winter Car. The game, if desired, inherits your saves, your story from the first part. Will we see the grandmother, or will we be able to deliver kill you to the drunk guy, depends only on us. Yet nobody knows how deeply this feature will be realized. It is still unknown whether we will see Suski with our daughter or whether we will pay money to her formally through bank transactions. A love story with Suski immediately reminds us of how it began, and yes, her ex-boyfriend and his friend in a yellow and a gray car will stay in the game, will change cars and perhaps will hang out in the same parking lot at Teemu. It is confirmed that Teemu would not kick the protagonist out of his store if he just comes inside to warm up. One of the new things in My Winter Car is the hypothermia bar. The temperature outside may drop to minus 35, and any heat sources are important for survival. For example, the house of the protagonist is heated with electricity, and the character inside is heated with hot food from a brand new microwave oven. When the heater in your car breaks down, winter clothing will keep you warm. By checking the temperature on the outdoor thermometer, we can put on either light or warm clothes. You will not be able to wear the same warm puffer jacket forever. If you go inside, you will start to sweat, and you will die wearing it just as I do now. When the frosts come, we will have a lot of winter entertainment. In the morning, you can go to the lake, drill a hole and fish, and this is no longer a disgusting trap for fish, as it was in the first part, but a real winter fishing with a fishing rod. The game will add the ability to throw snowballs. If a neighbor walks past you, throw a snowball at his face, let him understand he is not supposed to hang around the fishing spot. In addition, we should expect a working ski slope, where we can ski or ride from the slope on a sled. In any case, you will first need to get to any place on the map. Problems can begin at home, when the rivet's engine refuses to start in the cold. It is possible that the locks will freeze in it. Once I actually climbed into the car through the trunk, so I have to say this is not the most pleasant morning. On a winter day, we leave the house and clear the rivet from snow. Traffic on the roads is slow. In Finland, the maximum speed is limited to 80 km per hour. In winter, some drivers in rear-wheel drive cars drift into the snow and throw in sand all over. We are going to the ski track through a blizzard. Look around, how it's beautiful. Initially, My Winter Car was really planned as a DLC for My Summer Car. It uses the same engine, the same physics and the same graphics. Like in the original game, it will not have a multiplayer, and it will also support mods. Even the computer with its games will appear in the sequel. Why is this a separate game? My Winter Car does not require the first part of the game to run. Its map will have many changes. There will be new gameplay, new music. The project car will be optimized and redesigned from scratch to increase FPS. And this is very good news. In general, all this turned the DLC into a new game. My Winter Car is the sequel to My Summer Car and is the last simulator from My Car universe. There will be no autumn or spring cars. There will be no DLC for it. The game will be sold in the old-fashioned way, entirely and immediately. The cost of the game will be the same as for My Summer Car. Those who have already bought My Summer Car are promised discounts. And you, subscribe to the channel, press the bell, and you won't miss news about My Winter Car, the release date of which remains unknown. But remember, winter is coming.